When you get a new iPhone, you may need to set it up. I'm going to walk you through that process. Don't worry, setting up your iPhone is easy and simple. Everything here can also be changed later after the phone has been set up. If you haven't bought your iPhone yet, I recommend that you ask them to help you set it up in the store. It's easier, and if you don't like it, you can easily change it in settings later. It allows you to begin using your iPhone right away. All current generation iPhones function pretty much the same. This video will be very useful for any iPhone. For the purposes of this video, we'll set up an iPhone 4S. Throughout these lessons, I will be following Apple's official instructions. These can be found at www.apple.com/support/iPhone. It is best to think of your iPhone as a tiny computer. First, you need to turn it on. The power button is in the top right corner of the phone. From now on, I'm going to refer to that button as the sleep-wake button. Once you see the Apple logo, your phone is on. It will take a minute for it to boot up. To prevent the accidental pressing of buttons in your pocket, the iPhone requires you to slide to unlock. Put your finger on the slider in the bottom left corner of the screen and slide it to the right. Now, you'll pick the language. I'm going to choose English. Then, click the blue Next button in the top right corner of the screen. Now, you need to choose your region. This will allow your phone to go to the correct iTunes store. Then, press the blue Next button in the top right again. Now, you'll need to enable location services. This allows Google Maps to find your location. And most importantly, it's part of enabling your phone to be located if it's ever lost or stolen. I recommend enabling this. Then, hit Next again. Now, you'll want to select a Wi-Fi network, also known as a wireless network. When at home, this is your wireless internet connection, which is usually much faster and won't count towards your 3G data amount. If you don't have one, then just click Use Cellular Connection, which is the 3G data on your phone. If you select a wireless network, you may need to enter a password. This is the same password you use to connect a new laptop to your network. Then press OK. Now, tap the Next button again. Now it will ask if your iPhone is your first iPhone, or you've had one before and would like to restore it from backup. Restoring an iPhone from backup will pull all the settings and data saved on your old iPhone and put it on your new one. If you're upgrading, I recommend doing this, although it can take a couple of hours, so you should be aware of that. Restoring from an iCloud backup means you set up iCloud on your previous iPhone and chose to back it up on the internet with iCloud instead of your computer at home. If you just want to start using your iPhone, just click Setup as New Phone. You can always restore it later if you want to. Then tap Next. Now it will ask you for your Apple ID. An Apple ID is your iTunes Store username or email address. If you've bought something from the iTunes Store before, you have an Apple ID. That's what you're going to use to sign in here. If you don't have one, you can set one up for free on your phone right now. The iPhone is a great place to do this. It's safe and secure. Then you'll need to agree to Apple's terms and conditions. Tap the blue Agree button in the bottom left corner of the screen. Then confirm by tapping Agree. Now you need to choose if you want to use iCloud.
With iCloud, when you buy a song on one device, it instantly downloads to all your others. Take a picture here, and it shows up there. And with iCloud, it all works automatically and wirelessly. So you always have the things you want, exactly where you want them.
I'm going to select Use iCloud. Remember, you can easily change these settings later. Next, it will ask you if you wish to back up your iPhone on the internet with iCloud or with iTunes on your home computer. If you choose iCloud, I recommend you have a wireless network at home. If you don't, choose your computer. I do, so I'm going to select iCloud. Now you need to choose if you want to enable Find My iPhone. This is the reason I recommended you enable location services earlier. Find My iPhone will allow you to find it if it's lost or stolen, for free. Enabling it will allow you to find it using your Apple ID and password. This is explained in more detail in a future lesson. I recommend enabling this, especially if you've been forgetful in the past. If you're using an iPhone 4S or above, you will be asked if you want to use Siri. This is a feature that lets you ask your phone questions.
What's my day look like?
Not bad, only 2 meetings today.
Can I walk to the Belvedere Hotel from here?
Here are directions to Belvedere Hotel.
Read me that text.
new message from Sarah Russell. See you soon.
Do you think it will snow today?
It sure looks like snow today.
Say hello to Siri on the most amazing iPhone yet.
If you never want to use Siri, you can select Don't Use Siri. But most people are going to want to use it. I'm going to select Use Siri. Next, Apple wants to know if they can collect anonymous data about how you use your phone. I'm going to select Don't Send. Either choice will not affect how your phone works. It will not affect your battery life. This information is sent each time you sync with iTunes. Registering with Apple makes life easier for you if your phone is new. It means your name will already be in the computer if you call technical support in the future. Then click Next. And we're finished. Thanks for watching.